C-H-A-L-A-N, chalan, means the movement or the motion, literally. Arohi and avarohi, which I have already done, arohana, avarohana, is the simplest way of showing the raga, the skeleton, like sa, sa ga ma pa, ni sa sa ni pa ma ga sa. This could be an arohi avarohi. But the chalan means the motion of the raga. It is little more detailed than the arohi. Sa ga ma pa ni sa sa ni pa ma pa ga sa. You see, it is a little more detailed. It brings out the raga a little more clearly than the arohana and avarohana. So chalan is the shortest possible description of raga describing the arohana and avarohana. And then comes what is very important is pakad. The word pakad, P-A-K-A-D, with a dot under D. Pakad means the catch or the, actually it means the recognizable feature. Each raga has got one particular recognizable feature. And for instance, I'll give you an example. In Marwa Thaat, using the Komal Re and Tivrama. Without using the Pa, right? There are three very important ragas. They all use these notes. Sa Re Ga Ma Dha Ni Sa Sa Ni Da Ma Ga Re Sa. No Pa. But this is no raga at all. This is just, you know. If it is Marwa, then it will be Ni Re Ga Ma Da Ma Da Ma Ga Re Ni Re Ni Da Re Sa. So here, what do we find? The Vadi is Re. Ni Re. And the Samavadi is Dha. Dha. So two important notes are balanced like this. Re, Dha. And you cannot stay long time on Ga. You cannot stay long time on Ni. Re and Dha are the strong notes. Ni Re Ga Ma Dha. Ma Dha Ni Re Ni Dha. Ma Dha Ma Ga Re. Now, using the same note, all the same notes, there's another evening raga which is very, very important and one of our major raga we consider, is known as Puriya. Just Puriya, P-U-R-I-Y-A. And the important note in this is Ga, and the second is Ni. Vadi is Ga, Ni is Samavadi. And there in Puriya, if you stay little more than necessary on Dha or Re, then it is finished. It will sound like Marwa. So this is what happens. Ni Re Ga Ma Ga Re Sa Ni Sa Ni Da Ni Ma Ga. So apart from the Vadi and Samvadi, which is the, already I have told you, these are the pakars. Like Marwa's pakar is Ni Re Ni Da. If you just do these three notes, people will who know the raga will know that you are singing Marwa. Re Ni Da. You don't have to sing anything else, it's Marwa. The moment one says Ni Re Ga Ma Re Ga Ni Re Sa Ni Sa Ni Da Ni Ni Re Ga Ni Re Sa. just ni re ga ni re sa. It is puriya. People would know immediately it's puriya because it's the pakar of the raga. Now the third raga, which uses again the same notes, dwells on the in the uttaranga, in the top part. It's known as Sohini, S-O-H-I-N-I. This is enough to for people to know that this is Raga Sohini. So, by the word pakar, this is what I mean, the recognizable feature of a raga. Many of the old musicians, when they want to, you know, try out younger musicians, they have a lot of fixed things, you know, in mind to be sure how much they know the ragas. They ask a younger musician, now sing Sohini. Just sing the Sohini main notes. So naturally the musician goes and sings this. Maga madani sare sa ni sa ni da ni re ni maga madani sare sa. Then he quickly asks him, now sing the antara of puriya. Antara means, you know, the second part. That's where you touch the top note. So you see, unless one knows, one has thorough command of the raga, it becomes a difficult job because, you know, he has to again go touch the sa, but in a different manner, because here the Sohini raga itself stays on the top and he has to sing puriya or marwa's antara, touching the sa. So all this comes after, you know, thorough training of the raga, which is entirely a different thing. And so all these, you know, things I have been trying to tell you are parts of the ragas by which a raga really gets established. But it is said by our great musician, with all this correct even, it cannot be raga unless you put the prana into it. Prana means P-R-A-N, prana means life. It can be just a beautiful, perfectly made wax museum piece, you know, which looks lifelike, but it won't have life. But to put the prana, that's where guru is necessary. It's only through learning practically from guru that you, after some time, each note starts throbbing and pulsating with their own life, and with the correct punctuation and the correct shrutis, the microtones and gamakas and all those things used, then the raga becomes alive. Then it is just like a person alive. Otherwise it will be just dead. And that's why it is said, in Sanskrit there's a word, just very short word, ranjayati iti ragaha, which means it is that which colors the mind, which moves the person, which sort of excites the emotion and the imagination, is a raga.